Hey everybody, welcome back to Super Mario Galaxy. In this video, we're going to head to the terrace, and we're going to go to the first galaxy of that dome, Good Egg Galaxy. So this is a pretty easy galaxy. It's like, you know, obviously after the Gateway Galaxy is the introductory one. And we're going to actually fight our first boss here. Alright, so let's get started. Okay, yep, and the first boss here is going to be Dino Piranha, and mission has the same exact name. Yeah, so when I powered on the game again, and I was looking at the menu for the 3D All-Stars, I saw the release date of this game, it was like November, and that's probably why I didn't really play the game that much at launch. It was because it was like around Thanksgiving, or close to Thanksgiving here in the US, and it was the busy part at my old job, so that's probably why I didn't start playing again until like when I started recording this for YouTube, actually, the first time. Okay. There we go. Alright, so we're gonna get that one up. That was just like a little mini game for the one up. Let's see if I can aim this right. There we go. This is not as good as aiming the Wii remote, or as like fast. You gotta like stop. Or maybe you don't have to stop, but I kind of have to, because I have to, like, aim properly. But, well, like I said, I'll hopefully get used to that. Okay. Yeah, I need to collect all these star bits, because I know there's, like, galaxies that you need to collect star bits to access. It's like the Hungry Luma. I definitely remember that. But yeah, as I mentioned in the last video, I haven't played this since probably 2010. So, you know, I'm kind of playing from memory. I mean, obviously, I don't remember everything that happened 10 years ago, let alone what happens in this game. So, I'm gonna, you know, play by ear, just kind of explore what I can remember. Oh, this is actually back at the beginning. I did miss some things here. I mean, I do want to show everything that I can, but I'm probably going to miss some stuff. But it's also stuff that I'm not, like, too worried about. Like, I think there was actually one enemy that I didn't see in the Gateway Galaxy. Something like that. I think it was, like, that money bag frog thing. I thought I read something about it being in Gateway, but yeah, I definitely did not see that. I think that'll show up in a different galaxy anyway, it's not a big deal. Okay, so let's go up here. Oh wait. There we go. Oh man. It's just like really taking me back, especially these first couple galaxies. These are the ones for some reason that I remember the most. The star chips. I'm missing two now. Okay, I thought you could break these. Oh, shoot. You just gotta time it right with the rolls. Yeah, I did mention that in the last video. My depth perception is not that great. Especially on, like, these spherical planets. Ugh. I don't know if I'll just keep going for those. I might just go. Yeah, I'm just gonna go. We'll have more opportunities for Starbits. Like right now? Oh, ow. Oh, jeez. I was trying to jump on him. I didn't know I would jump right in his face and dully whiff. There we go. And more of these rock things. Yeah, this music is so good. Oh, you know what? I could probably hit this green thing on it. Yeah, that's more safe. We didn't have those on the previous planet, but this is nice. Okay, yeah. It's like a limit. Okay, I thought I had to like step on his head after hitting him. Okay. Alright, I'm so used to collecting coins, like 100 coins or whatever. Or like, because I played Super Mario Sunshine recently on my channel, like a couple months ago. So with that game, I did get to the end, but I didn't 100% complete it because of the blue coins. That's definitely my least favorite part of the game, like getting those blue coins. All it was just padding for the game, because the game without the blue coins is a decent length, but yeah. Alright, this is Dino Piranha. He's kind of hiding his egg. I'm gonna destroy some of this stuff so we have more room to run around. Although I should have saved that coin, just in case. But yeah, for Super Mario Sunshine, I'll resume that. You know, 2 weeks ago I didn't know there was going to be an HD collection that will included Sunshine. So I'm wondering if I should just like go through the game again, or just resume my save file on the GameCube. I might just do the latter, because I don't know if I feel like going through that game again. Like, don't get me wrong, I love Super Mario Sunshine, but I just went through most of it very recently, so I don't know if I feel like doing that again. Plus, this is the priority. Super Mario Galaxy is the priority. I mean, I do want to play, maybe not for YouTube, but just for fun, Super Mario 64 again, or like on a stream or something. I did go through that game, it's been a long time too, almost 10 years, probably like 7 or 8. Okay, there we go. Okay, that was the first boss of the game, Dino Piranha. He's really easy. We will see him again, but later on in the game. But for now, we're going to collect our first regular Power Star. Him some star bits, even though he doesn't really do anything, it's just like a tutorial. Yeah. All right, cool. We're just going to keep the momentum going, and we're going to continue with Good Egg Galaxy. We got two more missions to go here. Well, for now. Okay, next up is a snack of cosmic proportions. Okay, you know, I kind of forgot that we see a hungry Luma so early on. He doesn't, like, unlock a new area. He kind of... I think we just feed him and he gives us access to a different planet that we couldn't get to in the first mission. Oops. Oh, shoot. Let me see if I can get up there. I did it in the first mission. There we go. Do I really want to do this again? You know what? I'll just do it again. I'm already here. Plus, I like this song. Oh. There we go. I thought I was gonna fail. Yeah, like I said in the last video, probably gonna need these extra lives for some of the later missions. Okay, let's get out of here. There's nothing else in here for us. But yeah, I am kind of disappointed that Super Mario Galaxy 2 isn't in this collection. I would have... I said that in the last video, but I would have loved to go through that again. I don't know immediately after this, but definitely at some point after this, so... I feel like they might release that, like, I don't know, on its own, or like in a second compilation. Maybe with like 3D Land and, I don't know, Super Mario 64 DS. I mean, that would actually be really cool. I wouldn't mind that. I would love to play Super Mario 64 DS again with actual analog controls. Okay, yeah, we already know that. This is gonna be weird. There's some galaxies that are gonna be really tricky. You have to use those pole stars. It's gonna be weird not using the Wii Remote for those in particular. There we go. Yeah, back to what I was saying. Yeah, I would love to play a collection like that. So, if Nintendo did a 3D All-Stars 2 with those three games, I would buy it. I think a lot of people would too, so maybe that was their intention. Although, to be honest, they really could have fit all six games on this game cartridge. Okay. You know what, I might try to destroy the rest of these spiky plants. Okay, I don't think I missed anything else here. Nothing else important, so yeah, let's get out of here. Oh, one star bit. Man, I remember the first time seeing this, it's just like, wow. It's flying through outer space, that's so cool. And, you know, honestly, I've grown up with like a lot of these Mario games. My first one The first one that I played was probably, it's either Super Mario Brothers or Super Mario Brothers 3. That's like the earliest I can remember, but the first one I owned was Super Mario World. And even the jump from like the NES to the Super NES, that was a pretty big jump to me. The graphics were like so much better. But I feel like the jump from, let's say for example, Super Mario World to Super Mario 64, that was really eye-opening, especially as like a 10-year-old kid, because it's just like, you know, going from 2D to 3D, that was something. And, you know, going from Mario 64 to Sunshine and then Sunshine to this game, you know, that's pretty cool too. But I think, I don't know if there'll ever be anything like the jump from 2D to 3D. Okay, so we're gonna feed the hungry Luma. He's 100. I should have enough. Alright, we fed him, and now there's a new planet available. You know, it's pretty interesting. The new planet is born, and then there's automatically inhabitants, and they're like not friendly ones either. So lucky for us, we gotta deal with these Goombas. You know, I'm so used to like the 2D Mario games. I like want to stomp on them, but I think it's more beneficial to spin on them and then kick them, because you get the star bits instead of the coin, unless you need health. One-up. For some reason, I don't remember this game being so generous with the one-ups. Maybe it's just early on. I'm sure they're going to be a lot more rare later on in the game. Ow. Oh, he spun off. Oh. Oh, okay, so hitting them, I guess anything involving the star spin with the Goombas, they just turn into star bits. That's good to know. It's like some knowledge that I didn't remember. Okay, well, we made it to the top. Let's spin here. Oh, the pill-shaped planet. Oh, I like this music. You know, I don't know like the official names of the tracks, but now that the soundtrack is included with this game, I can know. I'll look it up later, though. Okay. Let's get all these star bits, and then I'll head inside. Hello. Oh, I think I missed one. There we go. Alright, now I gotta find the entrance here. Oh, here we go. Yeah, that's something else that's really cool about this game, like the change in perspectives. It's like very seamless, it's awesome. I could take like a shortcut here. Yeah. All right, I'm gonna go for it. Oh wait. Oh, I don't want to be over there. Oh wait, I'm going backwards. Oh, I wanted to fight them. Oh well. So, This should be... Yeah, this is the final spot here. Okay, yeah, we just gotta get the rest of these blue star chips. I gotta get used to, like, the gravity here, because I'm so used to playing games where you fall off, you just die. This one, you know, you just walk over to a different side. Okay, well, I did say this is gonna be kind of weird, so, let's see. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this is definitely weird. Wow, this is like really disorienting. Okay, I got it. Oh man. Okay, we're gonna head back to the Good Egg Galaxy. So, before I started uploading this, I was wondering how I would do this playthrough, like, formatting-wise. And for those that remember, when I uploaded this game originally, I had one video for each mission, which, you know, at the time I really preferred, and I wouldn't mind doing that again, but at the same time, it's kind of like a lot of videos. That was like 120 videos. Well, more than that, if you include Super Wii Galaxy, so that was at least 240 something videos, and I didn't want to do that again, so I just decided to, you know, condense a lot of the missions into a video or so. So what I'm gonna do is try to get through the missions that I can in each galaxy, and then move on. There will be some galaxies that pop up that have like one mission, and I'll include those with some other ones, like the major galaxies, but that's pretty much what I'm gonna do for this series. Okay, next up is King Caliente's Battle Fleet, and we do have another boss fight so soon, which is pretty cool. We're gonna fight his little underlings here, and we'll make our way to King Caliente. It was interesting, in the second galaxy, it might have been a relative of his, but there's King Caliente in this game, there's Prince Picante in Galaxy 2. Get out of here. Grab all these star bits. Those things are really annoying. Oh man. Yeah, like I mentioned earlier, I played Sunshine recently and they had the... I don't know what they're called, the little pink things that latch on to Flood in that game. Those are pretty much the equivalent of that in this game. Okay, so let's keep going here. I'm assuming this is the way to go since all his underlings are kind of guarding the path to him, which is a pretty nice touch. Oh, maybe not. Just guarding those star bits, I guess. Oh. If I kept going up. You know what? There were two guys guarding this, so this actually was the way to go. But it's not all bad. We got a bunch of star bits. Yeah, I love the design of some of these galaxies. I mean, this is just the first galaxy. We've seen, like, really unique designs already. Then the first mission, we saw, like, the Yoshi Egg Planet. Which, you know, when I first played the game, I thought we would see Yoshi. But, spoiler alert for those that haven't played this, he's not in this game, he's in the second game. But there is a little reference to him in this galaxy. Oh. Oh, I missed that one. No. What if I can... There we go. I like vaguely remembered that you could do that. There we go. Alright, let's move on to the next beach planet. Oh! Okay. I love doing that. Oh no! Wait! Oh man, I was trying to spin on him. It's okay. Alright, we're on the, I guess, Chomp Moon now. I don't remember what's in this pipe. Let's check it out. Oh, okay. Oh, nice, the rainbow star. Wanna get all the star bits? Okay. Yeah, I like the rendition of the invincibility music in this game. Yeah, destroying those chomps gave us a lot of star bits. Alright. I mean, I know you can aim at these to stun them. Oh, the wrong button. Oh, you just got squished. You staying there for a little bit, too. That's probably the safer way, although I'm not touching him because he went behind that electric fence. Oh, what? Oh, weird. What is going on? That was kind of weird. I was being kind of pulled to that. I don't know if I was just like in the wrong spot, which I probably was. There we go. That's better. Yeah, this screen right here, this just looks cool. Oh. Gosh, the bullet bills are a lot faster in this game than I remember. So all the bullet bills act like bullseye bills in this game, they track you. Oh, not this thing again. Get out of here. Ow. There we go. Alright, I'm gonna sit up for this one. I saw the airships in the distance, and like, yeah, some stuff's about to go down. You know, I thought there was something else on this ship. Some coins. Oh, oops. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa. What is going on? Okay. Oops. There we go. And... Oh! What? That's kind of weird. Thought he was going to wear the coconut on his head. Like, what is this, Super Mario Maker 2? What's going on? There we go. Man, when I was playing through Super Mario Sunshine again, I definitely missed the star spin. It's such a simple attack, but it's so fun to use. Oh, nice. Those mushrooms are always nice to have. Alright, hopefully I won't need it against King Caliente, but... Like I said, it's been 10 years since I last played this game, so who knows. King Caliente, he's just a big octopus dude, and he's more difficult than Dino Piranha, not too bad though. I think it's a fun boss fight. Yeah, Nintendo has like a interesting taste for bosses that you have to like reflect stuff back at, like Ganon or Phantom Ganon, whatever. All right, that was it. That was the boss fight. Pretty easy, but of course, there's only a fourth mission, so can't expect something that difficult this early. Alright, let's get it and move on. Okay, that's it for Good Egg Galaxy. I think we go back later on. I can't remember off the top of my head. But we do have enough stars to get to the next galaxy, which is Honey Hive. So we're going to get to that in the next video. That one's a cool one. We get like another power-up in that one, so that's going to be fun. But yeah, thanks again for checking out the playthrough. Hopefully you're having fun watching it as much as I'm having fun going through it again. I just love this game. It's such a good game. I'm glad to be going through it again. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.